In this video, we are going to discuss the solution of the delegation problem. So that problem is in the USACO 2020 February Gold Division problem. In the problem, we have a tree with 10 power to 5 at most edges and nodes. And we have to partition the rods into the paths of the same length. And we must determine which lengths are possible. So this is a tree with n nodes, so we have n minus 1 edges. So the length of the paths can be between 1 and n minus 1. So for each value of k, we must determine if it is possible to partition, to divide the rods into the paths of the length k. So in the sample input, there are 13 nodes and 12 edges. And those are the values from 1 to 12. So for that tree, it is possible to partition the rods into the paths of length 1, 2, 3. But for other k values, it is not possible. So this is another tree problem, a problem in USACO. To solve that problem, first we must make some pre-calculation. For each node, we have to calculate a number of the edges in each subtree, in each branch, actually. So the first step is pre-calculation. So for each node, we should calculate number of edges of each branch. So we can consider each node is the root, and for each subtree, you should calculate number of the edges, but also you should add the edge between the root and the root of the subtree. So because of that, I call this one branch, not subtree. So this branch actually will be number of the edges in the subtree plus one, the connection between the root and the root of the subtree. So for example, for that pre-calculation, we assign one arbitrary node as the root. Suppose that one, we assign one as the root. And with one depth first search, we can calculate all those values. So here we make a depth first search. So if we start from one, we go all the way to the leaf nodes. And for the leaves, for example, for five, so it doesn't have any subtree. And for each node, we make it like that. We calculate some of the branches in each subtree, then make a calculation to find the number of the edges in the parent site of the subtree. For 5, it doesn't have any subtree here. For the parent site, the number of the edges should be total number of the edges plus sum of the edges of the subtrees. There is no subtree, so it will be n is 13. There are 12 edges. It has only one branch, and in that branch, there are 12 edges. Here, we can call total number of edges as m, and it will be n minus 1 because this is a tree. So this is total number of the edges in the tree. So we call them m. Then for example, it is one subtree, one branch actually here. It is only one edge. So in one branch, it has one edge, and for the parent side, it will be 12 minus 1, 11. So 4 has two branches, and in one branch, there is one edge, and in the other branch here, there are 11 edges. And 3 is a leaf, it has m edges in one subtree, and same for 7, for 13. Because those are the leaves, and for 10 it will be the same. Let's continue here. For example, After 10, we go to the 9, and it will be 1 from that subtree and 11 from the other side. And same for 12, 1, then 11. For 11, it has only one subtree. Here it has two branches. And for the other side, it will be 12 minus 2 is 10. And for this 8, it has two subtrees here and the parent side. So for those subtrees, in one subtree, there are two edges here. In the other one, there are three. From those numbers, we can get them directly. This one has one in this side, and plus one is two. And 11 has two in one side, and plus one is three. And here for 6, it has two subtrees. In one side, this one has one branch. And in other one, we have, and here we forgot one note, because in one subtree, there are two, in the other one, three, and the parent side, we forgot it. So in one subtree, two, in the other one, three, 2 plus 3 is 5, and 12 minus 5 is 7. So for this one, in that one, there is 1. And in the other part, 2 plus 3 is 5 plus 1 is 6. And 12 minus 7 is 5. And for 2, in one subtree it has 1. In the other one it has 2. In the other one it will have 7 plus 1 is 8. And sum of them is 11, 12 minus 11 is 1. And 1 is the root, it has only one subtree, and actually 2 like that, 1 plus 2 plus 8 plus 1 is 12. So in the first search, we calculate those values for each node, number of the edges in each subtree. After that, for the second part, for each k, so those k's are, for one we have always solution actually, but this one from 1 to m, we make one more calculation. So for each k, we must check each node, and in each node, one of the subtree, the number of the edges in one subtree must be a multiple of k, so this subtree will be okay itself. If it is not multiple of k, the remaining subtrees must be pair up, 2 by 2, like that. If this is the current node, and it has some subtrees. Let's say k is 5, and here we have 10 edges in this subtree. In that one we have 3 edges, and here we have 12 edges. So this subtree will be maybe okay itself, because this is a multiple of k. So we just eliminate this one. And in that subtree there are 3 edges. It cannot be okay itself, because 3 is not multiple of 5. And also here, this is not multiple of 5. We find the remainder actually here. So this is 10 modulus 5 is 0. Because this is 0, we just eliminate this one. 3 modulus 5 is 3. So after we use the edges, the remaining edges will be here. So 3 here. So there will be 3 remaining edges. We must pair up those 3 edges with another subtree of the current node. And here this one, 12 modulus 5 is 2. So this remainder is 2. This one is 3. And 2 plus 3 is 5. So we can pair up these two nodes, these two subtree, because we have 3 more edges here and 2 more edges here. 3 plus 2 is 5. So for k, this node is okay. But we must check this condition for each node, for each k. So for each k, the second calculation, we must test each node if number of edges is multiple of k, or the remaining edges can be pair up. Of course, for the current k. So let's try 1k value. For example, let's suppose that k equal to 3. So starting from the first node, it has only one branch and 12. 12 modulus 3 is 0. So node 1 is okay. So for node 2, we have 1, 2, 8, and 1. So 1 and 2 can be paired up. 1 plus 2 is 3. 8 modulus 3 is 2. So the remainder is 2 for 8. We have 2 extra edges in that branch. And 1 edge in the other one. 2 and 1, we can pair them up. So 2 is okay. 3 is already multiple of k, 12. For 4, we have 1 and 11. So remainder of 11 will be 2. So 1 and 2, we can pair them up. For 5.